Here's the...
Thank you.
April 17th, Easter Monday, the church office is closed. Please also note that April 22nd is Earth Day, and April 30th is Native American Sunday. There being no further announcements, there is a further announcement? Okay, please also note that today our church family will be honoring the memory and recalling special moments of our dear friend Hilda Williams during our service. Another announcement, Claire? Coming. After the service, SPRC will be hosting a brunch to which you are all invited. Anything else? Okay. There being no further announcements, please share the sign of peace with your fellow members and visitors. The peace of Christ be with you.
Thank you.
the Lord.
The righteous shall enter through it.
Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw.
We thank you for that you have answered us.
We thank you that you have become our salvation.
That the stone has been removed from the tomb.
The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone.
This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes.
Please be seated. Let us now humbly confess the intentional or unintentional sins of our thoughts, words, or deeds in silent prayer.
Take it back to the preschool if you want, and y'all can hang out there because he really likes it. They know how to make a party happen. So as our children are going back to preschool to hang out with Wanda, I just want to thank her, thank Wanda, and all those who helped with yesterday's Easter egg fun. Those children should be hyped up on sugar for a long time to come, because each of them got 40 eggs. And so there was a lot of candy, and there was a lot of fun, and Lee helped them make tombs and have a stone roll in front of it, which was a cookie, and grass that was green candy sprinkles, and they did all that stuff, and they had crafts, and Ray taught them how to sing a song, and I told them the Easter story, and then they went out there, and it went bananas, and got eggs, and it was a production, and so it takes a lot of hands. So for all those who helped to help our community children to have a great Easter and to hear the Easter story, especially because that was really what we wanted them to have, more so than candy and anything else. We want them to know the story of the resurrection. So and so that was a great day. So thank you so much for all of that. For our visitors, so this is the time when you talk back to me and you share your prayer requests, you share praise reports. Wanda, I was just talking about you. You share praise reports and you share prayer requests and you lift them up so that the community can hear what you need. And that is why we are the church, so that we can come together as brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, as the body of Christ, and share what's going on, what we need from each other in our lives, so that when we lift those prayers up to God, that God is pleased not only that we care enough about each other to pray for each other, but that we do it in a community. And so, what are your prayer requests? Somebody has something to pray. Yeah. See, I was looking. So I saw you saying yes.
I'd like to say it's good to have the Cofield family back here. Jack recently passed away, and that's his children and Sue and the family back here at the back of the back second family.
Yes.
Susan and all the family.
It is good to have you here. We're so pleased to see
Absolutely.
You, and we continue to keep you in prayer during this time. Yes, ma'am.
It's a word of praise. My niece Samantha, okay, she's been accepted for the same Sweetbriar, and also a soccer club, they accepted her. But now they just have to, they're applying for a loan, so it depends upon all that they've accepted her to soccer and everything. So it's a word of praise.
Oh, wonderful. So she is on her way to higher learning. Great. Wonderful. Yes, ma'am.
I just want to thank everyone for this beautiful Sunday morning. The flowers on the altar are beautiful. The banners Michelle Elder made are absolutely gorgeous. The choir, they're beautiful. And special thanks to Larry Robinball for that wonderful railing that we now have on the altar. Now we're really hard to get that.
Yes. Michelle, I wasn't looking up high enough. Great. Thank you. Those are brand new. And yes, to Larry and to our entire trustee team, the railing looks like it's been there since the church was built. And so that is just, so we're thankful for those who work hard to help our church to be more inclusive. So those who have a little challenge getting upstairs now can get up the stairs. And so we're thankful for all of that. Of course, the flowers are gorgeous. Michelle, I like them. Okay. Are there others? Yes, ma'am.
Just a praise for families. We don't often get to see our children and grandchildren all at the same time. But today will be one of those opportunities.
Absolutely.
So I'm thankful that we still have family that we live close enough Unlike you, we don't have folks in Georgia.
Right, yeah.
The farther they are away from us because of their businesses and private matters.
Right.
So it's nice that they can make the time.
Yes, it is. Thank God for family. Family is a beautiful thing. It is. Are there others? Yes, ma'am.
Just like to thank God, thank everybody for their prayers, and Chuck was able to be here and sing so beautifully.
Yes, so if you were not here for Good Friday service, Chuck Dick came in and played Simon of Cyrene and sang for us. And we have been praying for Chuck. He has been going through healing from cancer, and his scans are all good and they're all clear, and he's just bopping right along. His mom even came, and she looked good, and so it was just a blessing to have them come and sing for us. Are there others? Man, y'all are quiet. Yes.
I think we should pray for, I just heard this morning, they estimated last year 75,000 Christians were executed or killed, mostly in a lot in the Middle East, the ISIS.
Yes.
Yes,
it is still very dangerous to be a Christian in certain parts of the world.
And other repressive regimes as well.
Say that again.
Other repressive regimes.
Yes, 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 yes. So let us pray. We need to pray for peace in this world. We need some. We need a double, triple dose of peace for our world so that no one is oppressed and everyone can be free. And so that's what being a Christian is all about, liberty. So let us keep our brothers and sisters around the world who are giving the Christian message and who are taking a lot on to do that. Let's keep those churches those pastors and those Christians in our prayers. Let us pray. Well, gracious God, on this beautiful day, a day that we have never seen before and will never see again, you give us this day as a gift. And so, God, we thank you for this Resurrection Sunday, this day when we celebrate where what seemed impossible, indeed it was possible with you. And so, God, we thank you for being almighty and strong and our protector and our healer. We thank you for being the one who cares for us when we mourn and who celebrates with us when we rejoice. We thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We thank you that he got up out of the grave and is alive and well and walks with us and talks with us and keeps us and helps us to be community and be in unity and be in peace and to have liberty. We thank you, God, because we have this relationship through Jesus Christ, that what has been done can never be undone, and that forever and ever your grace reaches to the furthest places of our world. God, there is no place where your grace cannot reach. And so, God, we pray for our brothers and sisters around the globe, those who are living in war-torn areas, those who are celebrating at the Vatican, those who are celebrating at the North Pole and the South Pole, all around the globe, God, we lift up our community of the church to you, God, and we reaffirm our commitment to you to do the work that you have called us to do through your Son, Jesus Christ, to continue to spread the good news that Jesus Christ is alive and well, and because he lives, we can face tomorrow. That's what the song says, Lord, and we hold on to that. And so, God, for those who are at this present time mourning, God, lost, we lift them up to you. Your word declares that you will comfort those who mourn. And so, God, we pray that your comforter would surround them and care for them and lift them up, that your comforter would remind them that to be present, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. That God, that you would continue to surround them with good people who will love on them and hold their hands and give them words of comfort and peace. And God, for all that we get to do in the service of your church, God, we thank you for those who use their hands and their feet and their mouths to serve you in your communities, God. We give you thanks. We thank you for hands that sew. We thank you for hands that create rails. And we thank you for hands that hide Easter eggs. And we thank you for hands that pass out food to the community who are in need. And we thank you, God, for hands that do the work that you've called us to do. We can't do it alone. And so we need everybody to join in. And so for those who have said yes, God, we thank you for their service. And God, we thank you just for family, for our biological families that we get to spend time with, and for the family of God, which we all get to be a part of. Not because we were so great, but because you love us. Simply because you love us. That's it. That we get to receive this grace and this mercy. We get to receive family that we can spend time with and break bread with and hold hands with and sing with and worship with and be in community with. And so, God, we don't take them for granted. We thank you. And God, for all the gifts that you give to us, there's no way we could ever repay you. But God, we respond by praying the prayer our Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
How many of you remember a song that we sing at Easter that starts off with, "Lo, in the grave he arose"? Oh, wait, I didn't make that right. "Lo, in the grave he lay, Jesus my Savior." And then the chorus goes, "Up from the grave he arose." How many remember a song like that? Anybody that would like to can come join us. We have a tradition in the last few years here at Trinity of inviting anybody in the congregation that wants to come and join with us on Easter Sunday morning. And I got the music for you right here. So all the people that would like to join in the choir and have the choir for one day, call it a congregational choir. And it's, like I said, it's up from the grave of the earth.
Thank you.
1 through 10. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly, with fear and great joy, and ran to tell the disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him and took his feet and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." Here ends God's holy word.
Thank you, God.
Thank you so much, Beth. Let us pray. God, we thank you for this holy mystery. Teach us what you'd have us to know about it so that we might go into the world and share the good news. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, happy Resurrection Sunday to each of you. If I have not had a chance to shake your hand or say hello, I am always thrilled by this great mystery that occurs in the resurrection. And so today's sermon really thrills me because it's the women. It's the women. Ladies, we are the first ones to tell of Christ's rising. That is us. And so it always excites me to read this because, and let me just say this, it took a lot of courage for these women to go in the dark to this tomb. It took a lot of bravery for them to even get up the nerve to leave the house and go to this tomb, not knowing what they would find when they got there. And so our first lesson for us is that in order to get the miracle, we've got to get a little brave. We've got to do some things that take a little moxie, take a little gumption, that we can't be afraid and then say, "Well, we don't know why it's not happening." We've got to step out there and do it because God is going to be waiting for us on the other side if we just take those steps. So if there's something in your life where you're a little afraid to do it, even though you know it's going to be good for you, take the step. Go on out there. Get out there. And yeah, it might be dark when you go, and you might not know what you're going to find when you get there. But just know if God is leading you there, when you get there, the miracle is already going to take place. When you get there, the miracle is going to happen. When you get there, you'll find that God has done 99.9% of the work. See, here's the thing. They were going to get to the tomb, and one, there's two guys standing there. What are they going to say to him? Them two. And then there's a stone that's so heavy that the four of them probably could not have even moved it. They roll a huge stone in front of a grave because they don't want the stench to come out. And they don't want anybody to go in and take the body. So they roll a stone that's so heavy, it takes a whole bunch of people to get it, to move it. And so they didn't even say, "Hey, what are we going to do when we get there? What are we going to do? How are we going to move it? What's going to happen? What about those two guys? What are we going to do about them? Oh, let's just lay back down. Don't worry about it." No, they got up the nerve and they got themselves together and they said, "We're going to this tomb. We're going to take care of our Jesus." And when they get there, lo and behold, God has already done the work. God has already rolled away the stone And God has a message for them. God even took care of the two guards. They passed out. The angel of the Lord came down in an earthquake and looking like lightning, and they just passed out. And the angel was able to tell them of the great miracle that had already taken place, had already happened. He looked at them and said, "Don't be afraid. I know you're looking for Jesus who was crucified. He's not here, for he has been raised as he has said. Come and see where he lay." And then he tells them to do some work for him. Here's the other thing about miracles. When a miracle happens in your life, you got to share it. Don't keep it to yourself. When God does something great in your life, don't keep it to yourself. Tell somebody. Tell your children. Tell your grandchildren. Let them know that you are a walking miracle. That the things that happened in your life have not all been good, but that God continues to move you forward in little miracles that God makes happen every day. You know, God is still in the miracle-making business. John, know that?
Amen.
God is still making miracles. I mean, shucks, we saw Chuck Dick sitting here, who has been fighting cancer. The cancer is in remission. And he came in here and sang like he had not had any sickness at all. He's a walking miracle. What miracles has God worked in your life? What things have you found yourself in that God has gotten you out of it? What things have you put yourself in? Okay. I know I'm not the only one around here that's not all that innocent. Yeah, okay. I know that I'm not the only one that's made mistakes and done things I shouldn't have done and said things I shouldn't have said and almost talked myself out of God's blessings, and God helped me anyway. I'm not the only person. Maybe it's just the two of us. It's just the two of us, okay. Where you have found yourself in something that you walked into, and God said, "My poor child, let me fix this for him." And God ushered you out of it and got you through what you had gotten yourself into. That thing where you say, "God, if you get me out of this, I won't do this again." That thing. And God got you out of it. Or that pain. And God got you through it. That loss. And God continued to walk with you and hold your hand and get you through it. That thing that should have taken you out. That car accident that you walked away from. That relationship that should have killed you but it didn't, and you walked out. Those challenges that come up in our lives, everybody has them. And God sees fit to make a miracle happen. Don't keep that stuff to yourself. That's the good stuff. That's the stuff that lets other Christians know that this isn't about being perfect. Because we know Mary Magdalene wasn't perfect. She has a past. A little checkered. And God chose her to tell the disciples that Jesus Christ has risen. Not only that, and here's the real great part. The great part is that they got to see Jesus for themselves. Now the angel told them, "Hey, Jesus is risen. Go back and tell the disciples." But then they get to see Jesus for themselves and be in relationship with them for themselves. They get to touch him and be with him. Jesus is such a good friend, such a great friend, that he didn't let them wander. Because can you imagine? Here's the angel, and that's impressive, right? Comes down in lightning and all that good stuff, and it's white as snow. That's impressive. But he's not Jesus. We want to see him for ourselves. And Jesus shows up and lets them experience him. When we are going through something that's challenging and we don't know if it's God or not, God will find a way to let us know, it's me. It's me. When you say, God, I don't know if this is the job you want me to take. Is this the job you want me to take? I mean, I think this is the job you want me to take. God will turn around and send you a message that says, no, it's me. It's me. God, you want me to keep going after this divorce? Are you sure you want me to get the... Are you sure you want me and the kids to do this? And God will find a way to let you know, it's me. I'm here with you. I haven't left you. I'm right here. I'm standing here with you. God, you sure you want me to be a caregiver to my mom? Gosh, it's so much work. I don't know if I can do it. I mean, maybe she'd be better. And God's saying, no. You're doing right. It's me. And so when God gives you those little messages to let you know he's right there with you, go for it. Because that's what they did. They went back and said, hey, we know that this is Jesus because we saw it. We had an experience with him. We know he's with us. And we came to give you a message. And they gave the message to the disciples. They told about the miracle. And so on this wonderful day where, I mean, it's almost like Jesus was like, well, it's Resurrection Sunday. Of course the sun is going to shine. On this glorious Resurrection Sunday, what miracles has God worked in your life that he wants you to share? Share them. I mean, that's the whole point about being a Christian, is we're supposed to be witnesses to the fact that Christ has risen. We're supposed to be witnesses to the fact that Christ is working out miracles in our lives. What miracles has he worked out for you? Tell them to your children and your grandchildren. Share them with your friends, especially those who are going through stuff and they're waiting for their miracle to happen. Do you know somebody who has been looking for a job for a long time and you know what it's like to look for a job? I know what it's like to look for a job and it's tough. It's a job, looking for a job. And you know someone who is going through that. Witness to them about the miracle that God made happen in your life. Have you come through healing and you know somebody who is about to go into surgery and you know that they're scared? Witness to them. God is going to bring you through this. God brought me through. Do you know someone whose marriage is having a little trouble and your marriage had trouble? Don't nobody know about it, but your marriage had trouble and y'all didn't know if y'all was going to, you know, work this thing out or not. And somehow you did. And now you know of a young couple that's going through similar challenges. Witness to them. You know, our marriage hasn't always been what you think it is. And they go, really? Do tell. And you tell them, well, he said this, and then I said that, and then we said this, and then it went. But God found a way to bring us back together. What miracles is God working in your life? And here is a clue. You're a miracle. You are a miracle. Each of us are miracles. You're sitting next to a miracle. Look at them. You're a miracle. You're a miracle. And you're a miracle. And you're a miracle. And these cute people in here who can't walk and talk yet, miracles. Yes, you're a miracle baby. Know that God is working miracles every day. God is in the miracle working business. Receive that miracle and then go out and share it with the world. Amen.
Thank you.
ascended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Now is the opportunity we have to give back to God a portion of all that God has given to us through our tithes and offerings. This is by no means our attempt to pay God for what God has done, but this is in response to what God has done, and it helps us to help our community. So let us give as giving unto the Lord. Sunday. So go out now and let everybody know you are a walking miracle. And may God, who blesses us with this great miracle of Jesus Christ who is our Lord and Savior and our friend, and the Holy Spirit that stirs in us the gifts that God has put in us to be the witnesses out in the world. May the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rest and rule now with us, now and forever. Amen.